Hello, I'm here at the Knitting Hive with Kellie, the owner.
Hi.
Of a new yarn shop that just opened.
Yes, right? We just sort of soft opened this week and we're selling products. It's fun.
So I'm really excited to come and show you about this yarn store specifically because she's carrying my yarn. This is the only store that I've done wholesale with other than down in Lehigh at Pettifor and Pearls. And so two yarn stores on opposite ends of the valley. So that's really fun. So Kellie, what inspired you to open up this yarn store?
So I've always sort of had a dream of opening a yarn store. I used to live in Durham, North Carolina, and I remember talking to a friend of like, someday I'll open a yarn store. And a lot of times it felt just like that, a pipe dream, like sort of escapism. And I had been looking to sort of shift my career in a different direction because I wanted to grow and develop more. And a yarn store seemed like the best way to sort of align some of my skills with community building that I've done in my career and my passion for knitting yarn and all fiber arts.
So what was your career?
So I worked in alumni relations for like the last 14 years. And so, which is basically providing touch points and connecting people in the community, which I hope to do within the yarn community.
So that's a good connection then, you know, transition
from
that into yarn. I mean, maybe not everybody would see that, but we see that when you're working with community. So the name of this yarn store is?
Knitting Hive. And so I have what I call my yarn trust, and it's family members and friends. And when in April is when I decided to sew it, like I'm gonna open a yarn store, I said, can you guys come talk to me and tell me what you think about it and help me sort of not make horrible choices? And I said, the first thing we need is a name. And at that time, I knew what my core values for the store were. It's make, include, and grow. Since I have worked with community building most of my life, building community is really important. And the other thing that's really important for me is inclusion. I think everyone should be able to feel safe in whatever space they're in. And I wanted to have a name that sort of focused on community and inclusion. And you know, knitting, we're all gonna want to be better, grow, and learn new skills. And so we were just brainstorming, and I wish I remembered who came up with Knitting Hive, but someone said it, and all of us in the room were like, yes, that's the name. Especially because no one liked the name Yarn Whore. So it's now Knitting Hive.
Nobody liked that name.
I thought it was funny, but yes, I can understand why they didn't like that name.
Well, I like it because for those of you who are not in Utah, Utah is known as the Beehive State, so you have the hive from there. I also like it because my name Deborah means busy bee.
Oh, so, I love that.
I don't know, maybe that's why I connected here, but when Kellie sent me a message about selling my yarn, there was just something about her. I just felt like, yeah, I want to work with Kellie. And then I got to come and meet her in person, and I just really like Kellie. So,
oh, thank you.
She's going to have a really great space here where you will feel like you want to just come hang out. So
that's so kind. Thank you so much. And I do. I want people to hang out. I'm sitting on one of our couches, and this is a place where you can come and knit and feel safe to be you.
I like how bright it is here, and things feel really open. So for me, that is really nice and inviting and welcoming. So tell me about some of your favorite yarns.
So I like a lot of yarns, which I think is typical of anyone who loves yarn. And I don't have it here yet, but there's this yarn that I actually bought at the Stephen and Penelope store in Amsterdam that's locally dyed in London called Ching Fibers. And I love their color. They have a yak silk wool blend, which to me is like knitting like on a different, you know, mental plane. I'm just taken to a whole new place. And so I'm excited to carry that. I also, there's this local dyer in the Great Lakes area who does this misty alpaca. I was at work in Philadelphia once, and I came upon a yarn store with this hand-painted yarn where it's basically painted every stitch is a different color. And so I like to knit sometimes just for the color journey. So you'll see that we have Noro and a lot of painted yarn. And it was probably my favorite knitting color journey that I've done. And also with that, I also have Noro, again, knitting color journeys. And then I have practical yarn because as much as I like color, I don't always want to have like a rainbow sweater. And so then I like, I like tweed.
We like color, you can
Yes,
see.
You can tell. Like, so we have Kelborn Woolens, which I'm so excited to stock. And they have just some of the most beautiful tweeds. And I'm like, I need a winter sweater in every one of those colors. And the other thing, I'm really excited about local yarns. So I'm carrying about 5 local yarns, and I'm hoping to build that up because it's a local yarn store and the local yarn community is important, right? That's why we're the Knitting Hive. We're a hive and we're gonna sort of support our community. And so I was so excited Deborah said yes, because I want our community also to include our local sellers.
That was fun. I'm gonna take you on a tour around so you can see how great her selection is that she's got already. They're not even really fully open yet, but she's let me come and record today, so yes. I appreciate that. But one of the things that you'll see is she has a lot of kits, and I think the kits are really fun. The ones that you've chosen are unique, different than what I've seen all around, so I really like that. But you have a wide selection of notions and kits and yarns, which makes it really nice.
Thank you.
This will be a great place if you're traveling and you want to come to a local yarn shop to get your souvenir yarn. This is a place.
Yes, and I'm hoping to have my website launched by next week. It's just been, you know, I left my job at July 1st and I've been just working crazy, a lot to get done. And so
you left July 1st and opened in August.
Yes.
All right then.
It's crazy. I need a nap, but I've enjoyed, it's been so much fun to like wake up at 5 a.m. and do data entry and think about the store, so.
It is really nice when you are so excited about what your work is. It makes it just enjoyable for everybody else. While I've been here, there have been quite a few customers that have come in like dancing because they're so happy about it. So, I'm not joking.
It's true.
You're really kidding me. Dancing, hopping around with excitement. So it's going to be a great place. Thanks, Kellie, for letting me come by.
Thank you so much, Deborah. Lovely to see you again.
See you.
Thanks.